Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome and lengthy tutorial series on DuckUI, SwiftUI in UIKit. You heard that right, SwiftUI in UIKit. Well, kind of. And today we are going to talk about debugging. In the previous video, I have talked about the smart print statement that is inside DuckUI, and that is a log. And if you don't know what DuckUI is, go ahead and take a look at the beginning of this playlist. And yeah, just take a look at all of those that come before this video, because some things that I'm talking about, I'm assuming that you already watched the previous episodes. So, debugging. Well, in the previous episode, we were debugging via the console, so we were logging out, and this looks really awesome, and it is very informative. You can see we are in the main thread, we are not on the main thread. Yeah, go ahead and take a look at the previous episode. But sometimes we want to debug on the simulator or on our device, on our views. So in Xcode 11, there is a border, kind of a blue border, that you can see what you are looking at the code. And yeah, we want to have that in DuckUI too. So we have debug, and today I'm going to show you how that looks. So first of all, let's remove all of these logs. They are super useful, but we are not going to use them today. So I'm just going to create this on a simple view, but you can use them on label, UI button, and so on. So let simple view equals UI view. And in the setup views with safe area, I'm just going to stack it vertically. Let's see, vertical stack. And let's see, I'm just going to inset this in setting by, let's say 24, why not, filling parent and a layout in our container. If this sounds kind of unfamiliar, then go ahead and take a look at the previous videos about stacks and what this DView controller is all about and how easy it is to use it in your projects and how helpful it is, of course. And yeah, you can see that I have written 1, 2, 3, and finally a simple view, 4 lines of code, and I will have that simple view on the screen. But now that the view is white, I just want to add a background to it so we can see our background color. Let's see the color. And this decolor is super awesome. Go ahead and check out the previous videos about color with DuckUI. And I want to use this light, let's see orange. Okay, let's hit Command R, and with these 4 lines of code, we have a simple view on our view controller. So how awesome is that? There we go, we have that with insetting, of course, and that is super awesome. We do have insetting here, and yeah, that's just it. Now, we don't really want to see this set background all the time, because yeah, we want to have that as white. So what do we do? Well, basically we add a debug. So let's use debug, let's hit Command R and see how super awesome this debug tool is. There we go. We have a background color to it. It's an alpha value, so we can quite look through it if there are views under it. And we have this nice border to it with some corner radiuses. It looks really, really awesome. So let me just for fun, let's add a new label here. So let label equals UI label. And I will just simply add a text to it. I don't want to change anything, but let's see. DuckUI is great. Okay, and yeah, again, how awesome is that? Let's just add our label here. And yeah, that should be it. Already, let's put it to the top, because I want to show you a problem and a solution to that. So here we have our label, let's say the commandeer, hit command R. Again, these are just 6 lines of code and we already have 2 views on there. So duck UI is great, and here we have. So let's add the debug to. Okay, let's hit command R and see how that it is. Duck UI is great, and now you already know that this label is stretching all the way to the right till here, and that is super awesome. Now, I didn't want to put this to the bottom because, yeah, you can't really see it on the bottom, but if we do add our view, let's say a height, set height, let's see, set height of, let's say, 200, and then we do have a spacer here, it will push everything up, and then we can add this label right at the bottom of our simple view. And yeah, you just move it around. And yeah, I just copy and pasted that, but let me just show you how I used to do it. So Command Alt and square braces, moving it up, moving it down. And yeah, with just a single tap of a button, you just move your elements. All of this is because of the stack and duck UI. So yeah, go ahead and check it out if you did like it. Now, one final thing, and I promise you this is everything, because yeah, you now know debug. You basically know how to do it. I just want to add a vertical view for this label, horizontal view, sorry. So stack the axis, let's have this as a horizontal, okay? And there we go, let's add our comma there, and let's just go to that line. So let me just move that a little bit up so you can see, just holding on Command Alt and the square braces, just moving it up, removing, or we are not going to remove because I'm just going to add another spacer here and maybe add some insetting there, let's say UI edge insets. Yeah, I'm going wild here, but yeah, this is how powerful you can just simply build out your UIs. And yeah, let's see, what's the problem here? Maybe there isn't any problems. Let's see. Maybe the debug needs to be added in front of the insetting. Yeah, so let's build and run. Oh, spacer needs to be initialized. Let's hit Command R and see what we have built. Well, basically we have inserted label and added a spacer here. And now you can see that under the debug, we are not having all of the screen to the right filled up with the label. So yeah, that's how simple it is. And now you can simply debug your code. Where are your views? What they are covering and so on with the debug. One thing you need to remember, that this debug is basically returning a UI view. So yeah, you can call it on any UI view, but it is going to return a UI view. So even if we have our label here, like we can add a text color or text, as you can see, we kind of cannot have a text here under the debug because it is a UI view. It does not have a text property. So there you go, now you have, you know about it. So, and that is it for debug and debugging visually with duck UI. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. And now it is your turn, go ahead and do comment down below. Let me know, how do you debug your views at all? Do you just simply add a background color as I used to have it? Or you would rather prefer to use DuckUI's debug? And I will see you in the comments down below, and as usual, in the next one.